start of quarter number two. It's Dolphin football as we begin. They have second down behind the sticks. And they get there to touch him down, Brock, but a big gain on that play.
I'll be honest with you, Kate. As you grow and develop as a quarterback, your arm gets stronger. These comebacks can be one of your favorite throws in your arsenal. Because if you trust yourself and you throw it before that defender breaks, you know there's yards to be had.
Are you a zombie now?
And he's taken down directly on that 43-yard line.
Huh.
The drive picks up here, first and 10. On the shotgun, Penix. He'll dump this one off to his running back, complete. And he gets absolutely popped to end that one.
I don't get it.
I call this quarterback's best friends. Some call it a safety valve, some call it automatic. But it's sure nice as a quarterback when you got a trusty running back over the middle of the field.
How is he immune to the mutation? So whoever you choose has this cell. That's stupid as fuck. That's ass. That's ass, Rallo. You're in a world by yourself fighting zombies. That's ass. How many people is really here, Rallo? That's your ass, Rallo.
Berrios now to return it. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30.
So let me be honest. I'm not going to say ass because this is a fun game to pass the time. It's chill. It got its scaring aspects, but it's a chill game. That's another reason why I like The Last of Us. Because it was, you had to use weapons, but at the same time, it was like a free roam game. And it was chill. You got to play it at your own pace. And this is solely just a one-player game. Huh? Oh, well, I see. Yeah, that really make it not terrible. And the Eagles tie this game 7-7.
The kick team out there for the Eagles, and this one is sent away. Starting from the 5. Good looking return here, and he's got room.
Yeah, it's cool. It's not a bad game.
The end zone, they have to scrap and fight through them.
At the same time, what's left to do when you beat the entire game? It's almost 12, though. I'm gonna get my ass up out here. I'll holler at you tomorrow. Alright.
Game, they needed somebody to make that type of play. Now it pushes their lead to a couple of scores and makes a comeback that much.
much more difficult.
You know, Kate, their offense did its part and padded the lead. Now it's up to this defense to make this two-score lead hold up and carry it across the finish line.
On is Little for the extra point. The point after splits the upright. And the Eagles double their lead to 14. The kick team out there for the Eagles, and this one is sent away. Here's a return from the 7. And he gets across the 30 before he's brought down. They've got first down from the 31. And he sent a man in motion. Penix on first down. He beams one deep right side.
Started the play as a defender, but gosh, he looked good, didn't he? Running it back, he looked like a receiver navigating on that return. The way he saw the field, evaded obstacles, and he chewed up yardage in the open space. That would make those offensive coaches and teammates proud. We've seen defensive players get touches on occasion, and I think he just gave himself maybe a look on that side of the ball down the road.
New set of downs for him from the 46.
In the football dictionary of staying on schedule, that was it.
They're set up at the 35 now. Play action now for Cousins. Oh, he got hit as he was throwing, and unsurprisingly, he falls incomplete. Second down coming up.
That's a very quick trigger, and the hurry throw was much tougher to complete. He may have rushed that one, thinking the pressure was just about to get to him in the pocket.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Working from the gun, it's Cousins. Moving quickly, trying to get set again. And a bump on the shorts. And he'll be brought down here at the 23-yard line. Just one quarter remaining in this one. This one not out of reach quite yet, but it is a two-score game to begin the fourth. Keep this drive moving and come to the line for first and 10. In the shotgun, they'll give it to him inside. And he gets absolutely pumped to end that one. Working quickly here. From the 16. The shot to the end zone is incomplete. Took his shot at 6 that time. And now they need to get 4 on third down. All movement on the line before the snap, though. This is going to be a false start. A costly false start penalty as third down becomes much more difficult to convert as they back it up 5.
Yeah. Exclamation point there. That caps off what, and I think you'd agree, Brock has been a dominating performance.
Yeah, I would. Really in all phases, too. You know, I thought coming in that this would be a much closer game than how it's turned out to be. And you got to give credit where it's due. This offense has been outstanding throughout.
Mm-hmm.
That one right down the middle. And the Eagles stretch their lead to 21. The kick team out there for the Eagles, and this one is sent away. Fielded at the 7. Returns looking good so far. Field flipping return as he brought it down on the opposite side of the 50. Ball on the 45, first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he's looking to throw. Trying to push it deep downfield. Score. They're still down 2 possessions. Time not exactly on their side as they try this onside kick. Oh, and the kicking team's got it. All right, partner, peel back the curtain for everyone who's watched this happen on Sundays. Win looks unlikely, but they're still trying this kick. What is the coach now saying to his offense before they run out there?
I can hear the great Tom Moore, longtime NFL coach, over and over. He would preach to us through the week during the game. Whoever plays the game the hardest, the longest, is going to win. My goodness.
Brought in inside the 20. And he hits the end zone. Touchdown.
Think of getting somebody with that type of mass rolling at full speed. Who's really going to want to stand in the way, wants to stop him anyhow? The answer, nobody.
And this is going to be caught, getting aggressive as they trail in this game, and that takes them 2 points closer. They've got less than 40 seconds to work with. Not impossible, but got to recover this kick. And the Eagles are able to recover, and that should just about do it for us here. They may have caught them a little by surprise on the last onside try, but certainly much more prepared this time around. That one is not successful.
Yeah, it's tough enough. The numbers tell all of us, right? It's tough enough to do it once, recovering 2 in a row. Well, that's borderline impossible, and that Hands team, they weren't going to let theirs die down a second time, that's for sure.
Oh, look at this. He's set up to throw. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. Couldn't connect on first. It's second down. From the gun, they go with Algier. And they'll bring him down after a pretty short game. Now the Dolphins call a timeout. It's their first. So a tough spot now. This is 3rd and 9.
simply take him off this field altogether.
The left side, and Gesicki has it. And he'll get it off to the 27.
He's just one of those guys, Kate. Even when he's not open, he's still a target, thanks to that physicality and his ability to just play bully ball. They don't like forcing into coverage, but sometimes when you've got a bully like him that can create space, just find a way to get him the ball.
Wanted to ask this, so this feels like the perfect moment, Brock. Is there ever a time where a quarterback feels intentional grounding is actually worth it?
No. I don't think so. Not for your team, not for your play call, not for your coach, not for the game situation. There really isn't a time. You've got to find an outlet somewhere to throw that ball away safely.
One final second on that clock. There's a timeout. We'll have to wait just a touch longer to close this one out. Setting up for the kneel down on third. Caught him across the line early there. That's an easy call for our officials. So after some careful consideration, they're going to